Hello and welcome to this game, or rather this replay, to be honest, or to be exact. I'm Imperator Ricardo, and I'm your commentator, as you might by now already know. We have a replay of Forima against Petru. We have 5,000 resources. I think the cap is off, and Netherlands. Both players are Netherlands. And so we might see some musket action or pikeman action, or late, early pikeman, later musket action. I don't know. My brain is not working correctly. It's 12:30 here. Half past 12 in the midnight since it is. And we can see that Forima is making some pikes. Petru is also making some pikes. And I'm thirsty again, but this time I won't drink. Forima building his diplomatic center. Petru also building his diplomatic center. I suppose they're gonna make siege Cossacks, archers, and infantrymen. Well, at least the siege Cossacks and infantrymen are correct. Are correct for Forima. And for Petru, it's the same. Also, some siege Cossacks and some infantrymen. Infantrymen make a good strike force in the early game because of the high attack. The health is a bit crap, but what can you do? Later on the round, she's a better, I guess, because they can take more bullets. But for them to be effective, they first have to have bullets that can be shot. So they have to go musketeers. And by that point, you want to have your own musketeers, so pikes won't be really relevant. There won't be any melee fighting anymore. Petru chasing down a siege Cossack from Forima. Petru also sending out some scouting drummers. Forima doesn't do that, surprisingly. Looks like Petru is gonna try to go for a cheeky little raid on Forima. If that's going to be successful, that's to be asked. Forima certainly knows about the presence of Petru. From both flanks, there was an infantryman that was cut down by the siege. And Forima's countering with his own siege. Forima's first group is going. First and second group, actually. For Petru, there's only one group going, but it has some additional archers. Petru trying to harass the groups of Forima with his siege Cossacks. Getting intercepted by Forima's siege Cossacks in the process. There are a lot of them, sire. And now I have to drink. Good old lemonade. unfortunately my last bottle. So there's a siege brawl going on between Folima and Petro now. Looks like Folima has the upper hand simply because there were more siege Cossacks engaging in the first phase. And sure enough, he survives with a lot of survivors, unlike Petru, who has almost no survivors. But there's still the army groups of Forima. And interestingly, Petru makes the Turkish archers, the mercenaries. You don't see that too often. Usually people just go with swift production methods, going normal archer mercenaries. Simply because it's a shorter while away from the click. So maybe save one nanosecond or so. And sure enough, Foruma won the pike fight. And considering Petro also had some infantrymen in there, that's impressive. Then again, Foruma had as well. So maybe there's that. It looks like Petru's raid on Foruma's base was in the meantime not successful either. Once again, pardon me for my lack of speech, but it's 12:30 in midnight. And I've been up for like a long time. Some peasants from Foruma probably going to save neutral control, but Petru is intercepting them. And then Foruma is intercepting Petru's Cossacks. And now Petro has normal archer mercenaries. A bit sad. A betrayal to the Turkish archers. Our Ottoman archers, rather. They were in Turkey back then. The whole Turkey thing is a thing of 1920 or so. A rather big army group from Foruma going in after Petru's rather large group of pikemen and infantrymen who just captured a gold mine without resistance. For some reason Petru's put off some siege Cossacks to guard a gold mine. I suppose they're gonna be swiftly dispatched. No, there's reinforcements, so the pikes are going to be swiftly dispatched. Looks like I am wrong yet again. No, I'm not. Petru running away from Foruma's northern army, while chasing his even more northern army, and being chased around by his southern army. I think if Petru isn't careful, he's gonna be sandwiched between two of Foruma's armies. It's a double sandwich. I like myself a good sandwich, but this does not look good for Petru. And sure enough, he's getting massacred on both sides as well. This could be over faster than anticipated. Petru lost a lot of manpower there, and it doesn't seem like he has the necessary upgrades to fight. Or does he? Would be a good time to play the Vsauce theme now. Unfortunately, I don't know how to edit the video. And I'm not going to edit it either because it would take ages for me to download and upload it. At least by now the chances should be equal, at least from the barrack upgrades. I don't know if they have some smithy upgrades or not. And Petrus scores his first victory against an army group of 40 ma. Congratulations, but it might be a bit late. Army group of 40 ma taking over the southeastern neutral control from Petru. But Petru blows it up just in time. Even blew it up after 40 ma actually captured it already. It was just a fraction of a second though. So the bugginess of the game allows that. I smell coal production, at least for Petru. What's he up to? He's up to Dragoons, a lifesaver, at least in this mode. Might still turn it around like that. I also smell coal production on 40 my side, so he might also go for some. Or he might be going for Musketeers soon, and just gets the upgrades, what do I know? No, he's also going for Dragoons. An equal amount of that was of those that Petru has. God, language today. Or right now, rather. Some mining upgrades. For the gold mine, I suppose. On Petrus' side, 40 ma already has those, so he has a gold advantage. Alright, Petru has the iron production advantage, and 40 ma also has the coal production advantage, but that's just... Never mind, now 40 ma also has the coal production advantage, iron production advantage. Damn it. Getting everything mixed up now. And Siege Cossacks are chasing Petru's Dragoons, who don't have any backup. might already make the whole shebang with the Dragoons to nothing again. Actually, the numbers seem equal right now, at least for this engagement. Of course, Petru lost way more Dragoons than 40 ma here. But he can still chase them down for a bit, and he decides to not do that. His production of Dragoons, however, ended just now, so he's gonna be stuck with these for a while. And since Dragoons get illegally expensive over time, he can't produce anymore until all of these are dead, pretty much. Why do mercenaries even let themselves be hired for money when they just die anyway? A mystery of the whole world to this day. At least I think that today there's still mercenaries out there. Of course on horseback, but modern ones. Anyway, there's a battle. And 40 ma now has the definite advantage with Dragoons. Petru has an armor upgrade, a smithy upgrade probably, and 40 ma does so as well. And 40 ma actually has two now. right in time for the engagement, giving him a massive boost for unit power. But, oh, Petro also has a second one now. So that doesn't, so it wasn't a boost. It was just equaling itself. However, whilst in the first moment it looked like Petro was about to crush that army easily, the Shield Dragoon Mass of Voluma made that, made him, scratch that plan. It might already end here and now, depending on if Voluma puts this up properly. Because Petro doesn't really have any defensive force right now. All he has is a handful of dragoons, some siege clusters, and a handful of pikes. Voluma has more. Not exactly on the front lines, but more production. What is interesting is that there's no stables. Nobody's building stables. Oh no, Petro's making stables. And he's going for knights. That's my man. I've never seen anyone use knights. Or if I did, that's extremely rare, and that was probably me. Oh, and Petro managed to crush the offensive army of Voluma. What a lucky guy. Still no stables from Voluma. Of course you wouldn't stand a chance against the knightliness of the knights. The charge of the knights. Voluma is producing dragoons again. I don't think that's common. I think once people lose their dragoon army, they stop producing those and instead go for upgrades or stables. Which he indeed does, but he's producing more dragoons, compromising his stable building capacity enormously. Well, I compromised my breathing ability because my nose is getting stuck. Stuff, brother. Four stables for Petro. Four times the knights. A very, very strong option against the pikes. They would just crush them instantly and leave more time for the dragoons to survive. Or let, in general, let more meat shield open for the dragoons to hide behind. To shoot the enemy dragoons. All in all, I think that knights have their definite advantages. They also serve as meat shield themselves. You just don't see them that often. Probably because they just are slower to produce. I think that Voluma is trading for his stables. Presumably food to wood. God damn it. I'm part of me again. It's late. The knights have arrived in the southern edge of the map. They are quite outnumbered though. They are however forced to be reckoned with. They have 10 bullet defense and the dragoons only deal 18. So only 8 damage is gonna get through and they have a large health pool of 300. You could say this is Sparta, but I say this is quite a lot. And Petro's going straight into the attack force. Petro's army in general is somewhere else, completely different. However, he's making round shears now. A good option against this Dragoon Horde. What is Voluma doing in the stables? He's also producing knights. What is going on around here? Normally you see only see people producing dragoons and stuff, but now they're all producing knights. I gotta say though, I like the knight attack. Iron Man has been taken over. Did I just say Iron Man? I meant Iron Man. Of course, you could also say that Iron Man has been taken over, but I don't think the Hulk would like that. Gold mine has been taken over. No resistance, no explosions. Petro on a roll. Killing 40 siege Cossacks. Then chilling, leaving his own siege Cossacks to die. He's still doing quite a bit of work, and now he's dead. I think by now both players have to fast the production upgrade. And of course they both have to have the cuirasses. And they both have knights, so the melee units are getting a... This is taking a turn for the 12th century already. With added guns, but let's just put that off as a crevice yes or so. Like, very early ones. They are from the future. The future. The future doesn't stand a chance. It looks like Forima is in the 18th century already. Yeah, his 18th century cavalry is unlocked. Whilst Petru is going for some cannons. Well, granted Forima is doing the same, but... Petru is not in the 18th century just yet, I think. No, he isn't. What is his idea? What is your profession? Petro going for a cavalry push. Or at least it looks like one. I can't even stretch my legs because I have to put my bag of crisps on my foot holder. I forgot the word for it actually. Still not in the 18th century. Forima is in the 18th century and he has the food upgrade. Food economy, best economy, as I always say. And I'm pretty sure that most people would agree, except for these old fossils that still prefer stone echo. It might be a bit stronger, but it's definitely not as safe. And here comes what looks like to be the... Here comes what looks to be the great push. So, you might ask that why is Imola producing 18th century cavalry? Is he producing knights? I think the answer is quite simple, because upgrading takes a while. And the knights are actually pretty decent against these pikes and round shears. He doesn't need a whole lot more than this. They already upgraded, they don't take any additional upgrade time, he has a lot of them. And the cuirassiers, while they are better against gunfire, and I think in general a little bit stronger, they just need too long to upgrade. and the time is not here in this game. In the meantime, Petru is just running down Foruma's dragoons with his knights. While Foruma's running down Petru's dragoon with his knights. A game of 2B to you. If that's even a game. Really long time. I feel like I'm just making up things right now. And it's a draw! Foruma lost too many men against Petru to push efficiently right now. He would just die regardless, so he should just pull back, I think, and recover, lick wounds and stuff. Foruma just bought the faster building upgrade. And he's, fair enough, he's starting to make the 18th century barracks. Petru, in the meantime, is still in the 18th century. Eventually, it's gonna be his downfall, I suppose. When the shrapnel shot from the cannon just murdering some knights. Few cannons getting captured. What do you mean, keeping out the bush? Despite that not going to be healthy for him. His infantry got shrapnel. The cannons are just trying to shrapnel each other. Unsuccessfully, Petru gets them all. Petru producing dragoons again. I think this is just a desperate defense measure. Because he needs their strong manpower. And Rangers won't cut it right here. The cannons are doing quite a good job though, driving into the enemy army. At least on my screen. Oh no, the cannons are getting captured. The battle is now all over the place, as Foruma seems to just stream in more and more men. But Petru has kind of the home advantage and can gather more forces together. And Petru's in the 18th century, finally, he's sending some peasants out. Alright, that's okay. Foruma is going for dragoons again. And 18th century pikes. The horrible spam starts. And soon they say my computer will melt. Really, I hope that this battle ends before the spam gets too hard, otherwise it just lags out. And probably crashes. Foruma still just streaming in. Petru in the meantime starting to produce Hussars. Interesting choice because Hussars aren't really good against infantry at all. They don't have the necessary attack power. They don't have the necessary health pool. They don't have the necessary armor. Their upgrades are expensive as hell. Only thing they're really good for is for fighting dragoons, and dragoons are not really the main menu here. The main menu are knights. And the occasional 18th century pikemen. And even those, if you just upgrade them once or twice, they are just going to murder any Hussar with their mass. So this is a very dangerous move. Petru going once again for the mercenary dragoons. This is a lot of gold wasted. Maybe an investment that has to be made. cannons are just standing there. Now they are shooting. A bit late and into the wrong target, in my opinion. They shot the pikemen instead of the dragoons. But the hussars are on point, trying to run over the dragoons. But there's some knights that say that they don't think so. And when the knights say that they don't think so, it's not like that. They're not gonna do it. I just lost the point myself. Oh, Volima has some musketeers 18th century. And some musketeers 17th century. And now the game starts to lag. That was lag spikes, not usual lag. I'm a bit concerned about that. Maybe I just crashed now. But it looks like it's almost game set and match for Petru. Volima seems to have the upper hand right now. And the game has stopped. Seems like that's it, I guess. Either it stops, or my game just shot itself. Well, anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening to my tired ramblings. I think that was an interesting game. Certainly very aggressive. Wrong decisions, good decisions have been made. Well played from both sides, especially from Petru for his valiant defense and long-lasting defense. I am Imperator Ricardo, speaking for this video, recorded by Call of It, and thank you for watching. Adios!